It's here at Surrey University where scientists are leading the world in research into satellite engineering. A new £2 million research centre, the first of its kind in Europe, has just been opened here to provide a base for investigations.
Already four microsatellites they've built, similar to this full-scale model here, are now in orbit and are being used to monitor the effects of radiation on satellites and how to improve communications.
This footage shows the last university satellite being blasted into space on board the Ariane rocket. At the moment, a fifth is being manufactured and is due to be launched in May. One of the major ideas being investigated here is how satellites could be used to help in the aftermath of major disasters. They're looking at ways of enabling satellites to talk to each other to speed up the relaying of information across the world. At the moment, what happens is a satellite beams its messages to ground stations, which in turn send the messages to the next satellite until they reach their destination. It's known as hopping and leads to longer and longer delays in communication. What's now planned is inter-satellite links, whereby satellites talk to each other, meaning information being sent around the globe far quicker. Something which could be a possible lifesaver. Such technology could be used when there's a major disaster to help medical teams, and by the Allied forces in the Gulf to help pinpoint enemy tanks.
What we will do is to use very high frequencies, or possibly even lasers, to communicate from one satellite directly to the next, rather than having to hop, as you say, from the ground upwards. And this will significantly reduce delays and also make it much more effective to transfer communications around the world.
Could it be used in terms of for disaster zones and that sort of thing?
Really, for all manners of communication, actually, I don't think it's specific to any particular application, but whether it be news gathering or telephone communication or military communications, any form of communications will be helped by this type of technique.
The new centre here, though, won't just be looking at the possibility of inter-satellite links. It'll be the base for international research, which will hopefully make satellite communications available to many countries, which up to now have found it to be far too expensive. This is Githa Hutton at Surrey University for Thames News.